From the Mike Eisenstadt Performance Studio, this is the Live Music Showcase brought to you by WMNF Tampa and listeners just like you. I'm Bill Dudley. I'll be your host for the next 55, and today in the studio, live, it's the band Broke Mr. Jones. Going to play some rock and blues, and some blues, and some rock. I think I covered all that, right?
Yes,
hey,
sir.
All right. Hey.
This song's called No Goals.
I like the ending. Hey, folks, we got Broke Mr. Jones. That's the name of the band. They're live. They're in the studio right here at WMNF. Hey, welcome, guys.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
Great to be here.
Let's introduce the members of the band. You want to do that or you want me to do it?
You can go ahead.
Well, we got Elliot Dickinson. He's the guy who was singing lead on there. He's also playing guitar and lead guitar. And we got next to him, we got Greg Baker. He's playing guitar also and doing some harmony vocals. Standing right in front of me is Sean Hartley on the bass. Hey, Sean.
Hello, everybody.
And back in the booth is John McDonald on the drums. Hey, John.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Hey, good to have you guys here with us today. Tell us just a little bit about this band, where it came from.
Yeah.
That kind of bio stuff.
Well, the band originally started with just me and John, and we were an electric guitar duo, I guess could be the proper yeah. terminology. And,
Hardworking.
Yeah, it was too much work. That's, I think, why we got a band at this point.
You got to add some more folks.
Yeah, yeah. So we got lazy, and that's the history of the band 101.
So, yeah, Sean and I are a crutch, everybody.
No, yeah. I don't want to give them.
Not really.
I mean, somewhat, you know, because it really is. It just makes the music so much more fun and, I think, enjoyable to play, but also enjoyable to listen to.
Yeah, yeah. So then?
So then, you know, I mean, here we are. That was really just last year. We've done a recording. We've got a full out. Well, I call it a full album. It's a 7-track album.
Mm-hmm.
Runtime of about 30 minutes.
And you're playing a lot of the songs from the album today on the show.
All the songs from the album,
yeah.
As long as we have time. If we don't run out of time. But I think it's about 30 minutes worth of music, and it'll be a really cool thing. So we're excited about that. It's not out yet. We mostly self-produce everything that we do. So.
And they can check out stuff about the band at facebook.com/BrokeMrJones, BrokeMrJones. How'd you come up with that name?
Well, good question.
Everybody asks about
yeah.
that, folks.
we started with I don't even want to confuse people with what the name was, but we started with a different name that was Broke Something. and we just eventually decided that didn't quite sound right. There are a couple of bands that had names that we thought were too similar, and so we decided to keep broke, change the name as little as possible.
So does this refer to your financial state, or does it have something to do with the music?
I think it definitely reflects our financial state.
Yeah. I mean,
whether intentionally or not.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, I guess, I don't know, I think there's fun meanings you can make out of it, you know? I mean,
well, we'll just leave it. We'll just leave it. We'll just leave the ambiguity in place for now. Let's have another song.
Wonderful. This one is called Coolest Thing I've Seen.
Coolest thing I've seen. She may have something that I've been waiting for. She may have something that I've been waiting for. Yeah. In a fairy tale, I want it that way. A little far off, but still I'm okay. If not a dream girl, something in between. Yeah, the nothing that I got and the coolest thing I've seen. Coolest thing I've seen. She may have something that I've waiting for. She may have something that I've been waiting for. Or she may have something that I've been waiting for. She may have something that I've been waiting for. Or we could be Irish hands, we could drink whiskey, and she broke it all after she kissed me. We never grew up, and I could be 16. Still, I've got a hunch I'm not the coolest thing she's seen.
Another surprise ending, folks.
We like to end on a button, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't know.
No, I love that song.
Oh, thank you.
That's out of all the songs you've done so far, I really like that one.
Stiff competition.
Yeah. Well, the band is Broke Mr. Jones. Now, is there a period after the Mr.? I guess there is.
Yeah.
Isn't there? Okay.
Yeah, we usually do MR dot.
So that's actually MR.JONES, folks.
Which is actually good to clarify for the Facebook page. If you are going to look us up on Facebook, you need to spell it Broke MR Jones.
No dot.
And you're not, or not spelling out Mr.
Yeah. You know? Yeah, not no MIST. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Elliot, Greg, Sean, and John are here. And putting out some good songs. Who influences whoever writes? Is that you that writes this, Elliot?
Yeah, I am.
Who are your influences in this music?
Man,
because I'm hearing a lot of interesting stuff.
Yeah,
just in those two tunes.
Yeah, my influences certainly change all the time.
Well, who'd you grow up with? Maybe it's a good question.
Definitely a lot of classic rock and stuff like that. A lot of music from the.
Now, when you say classic rock, do you mean like?
I mean all AC/DC. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, I mean the Beatles. I mean you know, for me it was really
Prince or
right. I guess
Queen.
Classic is vague these days.
Yeah,
it's like
classic could be.
I could mean Motley Crue, but no, I don't.
It could be Glenn Miller.
Right. Yeah. Well, and I don't know. You certainly keep going back further and further as you discover sometimes, but.
Well, I like the way you went into the little reggae rhythm there. That was really nice.
Yeah,
really
thank
nice.
You.
Wow. We're listening to Broke Mr. Jones, and if it sounds good, it's all the fault of Mr. Mark Perfetti, who's in the control room, as he is most shows, our mixologist today, sound mixer Mark Perfetti, doing a great job.
Yeah.
He's assisted with the setup by Allison Hickey, but she's running camera today, along with our video crew, which is director Bob Hoke and cameraman Richard Stone. The associate producer of this here radio show is Mildred Matos, and our producer is Steve R. Duango. I'm Bill Dudley, and if you want to get a hold of any of us, you may do so at livemusic@wmnf.org. If you want to send a message to Millie in the control room, you can send it to dj@wmnf.org. We've also got a text number where you can text Millie at 813-433-0885. Or just give her a call at 813-239-9663. Got all that? So, livemusic@wmnf.org is the way to get a hold of Steve and all of us. If you want to be on the show or you know somebody you think ought to be on the show or you want to make some kind of comment about the show, this show should be 3 hours long or whatever, you know, anything like that. Hey, let's have another song.
Excellent. Alrighty. This one is called Didn't Give Me the Chance.
I'm glad you didn't give me the chance to disappoint us both. If you didn't tread as lightly, you surely would have gotten too close. She's a fox, no doubt, and it's plain to see, but is it worth it to be shackled to her chastity? I'm glad she didn't give me the chance to disappoint us both. You found another man you think will treat you right. Maybe he can be the one to walk you home when it's late at night. But he won't get a chance to really make you sing. Not until he wears a pointless wedding ring. I'm glad you found another man you think will treat you right. Alright. Got so many chances. Wanna thank you again for calling me handsome. Yeah, I'm really to see you blame yourself. What's the difference though? I ain't got nobody else. Hey. Your definition of that word to be rather odd. It's not that I say you ain't worth the wait. Life is short though and I gotta be straight. I'm glad you won't save yourself for the love of God. Oh God, oh God. I'm glad you didn't give me the chance to disappoint us both. is that he surely would have gotten too close. She's a fox, no doubt, and it's plain to see, but there's a flaw in her ideas and philosophies. I'm glad you didn't give me the chance to disappoint us both. Disappoint us both. Disappoint us both. Again for calling me handsome. Yeah, I'm really to see you blame yourself. What's the difference though? I ain't got nobody else.
I'm enjoying these guys, folks. It's Broke Mr. Jones. That's the band we got here today on the Live Music Showcase here from WMNF Tampa. Elliot on the vocals and Greg playing El Scorcho lead guitar on that on that tune.
Yeah.
That was great. We got Sean on the bass and John on the drums. And let's talk to each one of you guys individually. Hey, John in the drum booth, how'd you get mixed up in all this kind of stuff?
Actually, Elliot and I have been close friends since high school.
Where'd you go to high school? Here in town?
No, actually over on the east coast of Florida, Satellite Beach.
Oh, okay.
We both grew up over there.
Near Kennedy Space Center.
All right.
Yeah, we played in projects back then, and we had a ska band together back in the day.
Oh, ska band.
Oh, yeah.
So you got a few ska influences here.
Oh, yeah. I mean, and we both grew up doing music in school. All the way through high school, and so I mean we have influences reaching all the way back to classical and stuff, classical and jazz and stuff that we were listening to and working on back then. So
wow, yeah,
yeah. What was I gonna say about the ska influence? I don't know. I had some crack about that. Now I forgot.
Well, that's John on the drums. We got Sean on the bass. What's your story, Sean?
Oh, you know, I just seen these guys playing in a bar without a bass player one day.
So like, these guys really need a bass player.
Like, man, you guys would sound so much better if you let me join the band.
I liked that approach.
And he was right.
Yeah,
who'd have thought?
Well, I'm enjoying. I'm standing right next to Sean here, and I'm watching him play bass, and he's playing at these really breakneck tempos, and he's really adding so much to the music. So I like that.
Yeah, thank you.
Are you a ska guy too?
No, not really. Not particularly.
Well, you are now, I guess.
I guess so.
By association. Yeah.
And we got Greg on guitar. He's going to be playing some keys a little bit later.
Yeah.
Maybe next tune. Who knows?
So maybe.
Yeah, maybe not.
Maybe sometime. It'll get there.
What's your story?
Yeah, so I grew up playing music. I took classical lessons when I was young.
On what instrument?
On piano.
Oh, okay.
So hence this little guy here. But. Uh-huh. Yeah, I got mixed up with these guys when I was in college. I knew them through some mutual friends. Saw them at a show and
Where'd you go to school?
USF.
Okay.
See, yeah. He says saw us at a show, like trying to make it sound cool, but we were actually playing like on a pool deck
at my apartment complex.
Yeah. And so yeah. It was that kind of show.
So show in quotation marks, I suppose. But it was cool. We talked, had a lot of similar influences, and started playing bass with them. And this is back in like 2011.
Uh-huh.
So yep. I've been playing with these guys off and on since then.
Not with
projects.
This, yeah, not with this project, but with a band of ours, the Rosewoods, which we'll probably also talk about in a little bit. But
okay.
Yeah, sorry, I didn't want to interrupt
you.
Thank
you for the clarification.
I wanted to add too that these guys like are definitely all three of them very responsible for the arrangements that you hear.
Well,
that
the arrangements are the arrangements are just great.
Thank you.
I'm enjoying that.
That's something that I don't want to sell them short on, because even on the songwriter, you know, I'll bring them something that oftentimes is not even really a complete song, and then we put it all together.
So well, let's have another song.
Absolutely. Forgot to tune a string. Sorry, everybody. This next song is going to be called I Believe in Something Good.
Music from Broke Mr. Jones. Broke Mr. Jones is the name of the band on today's Live Music Showcase. Thank you.
us from nowhere, nowhere to be. Never questioned him, nothing, slept comfortably. How it pays to be naive. Life is a magic trick with the dove up your sleeve. And I believe in something good.
Music from Broke Mr. Jones. That's B-R-O-K-E-M-R, period, J-O-N-E-S, Mr. Jones. Broke Mr. Jones, the name of the band. On our show today, you can check out their Facebook page at Broke Mr. Jones, facebook.com, Broke Mr. Jones, without the period. And also, they got some shows coming up. You want to talk about that for a second? I see you're going to be, in about a week from now, you're going to be at the Green Bench Brewery.
Yeah.
In St. Pete.
Enter other band.
Yeah. And also the Rosewoods will be there, which is some of the same guys.
Yeah. In fact, everyone except for Sean, and it's not like Sean wasn't invited to the band.
But he'll be there with the other band, with you guys. Yes.
Well, actually, just to clarify, that's kind of the funny thing about this group is that we don't book a whole lot right now because we play with all these other projects. The three of us, all of us except for Greg, are at least part-time working musicians. So we play, you know, we sometimes we're playing Mustang Sally to tourists on the beach, or at least, well, we could be, but we outlawed that song.
I can understand.
the gig, the two gigs in May are actually with our side project, the Rosewoods.
Okay. Which is three of yous.
three out of four of us, and we also just released an EP, a four-song EP with that group.
Now, how about so every Tuesday at the Ringside Cafe? Is that the four of yous?
That's not. That is also the two of us. See,
okay, the two of you. Okay.
Yeah, that is just me and Sean, and that's part of kind of like one of our, bread gigs and
okay.
just a good gig that's a regular thing where people can come out on a weekly basis
that
and listen, you know, and it's really cool. It's
okay.
Yeah.
Well, I hope there'll be some places that you'll let us know about on Facebook where all four of you.
We have September 22nd at the Blueberry Patch. We're playing.
Well, I don't know if I can wait that long.
Well, I mean, hey, any of you, you bookers,
I don't mean to
listening.
Be whiny here or anything, but you know, I mean, be nice.
Yeah, it would be nice to play more. And, you know, I mean, partially...
You available for bar mitzvahs and stuff?
Hey, man.
Weddings?
Hey,
absolutely.
We'll take it.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, okay, you can get a hold of them on facebook.com/brokemrjones. I think it'd be worthwhile. So, and they got their album coming out in the fall. And let's see, what else do I need to know about here?
Well...
Go ahead.
No, I think that's it. You mentioned okay. the album. Yeah, the album, I mean, part of the reason that we haven't had a whole lot on the books is because we are kind of a new name around town, and not to make excuses because we could be doing more, but we're really excited about this product, though. And when that comes out, that's going to be a big push for us. But like I said, you know, kind of producing it ourselves and...
it's a lot of work.
Employing people who have day jobs and... come yeah. home, and then we're like, hey, you want to spend your evening working on this instead of, you know, relaxing and having dinner?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, so, I understand that.
Yeah.
But folks can watch this show on our new YouTube channel.
That's awesome.
And the YouTube channel is, you have to type in WMNF 885 FM, all run together. WMNF 885 FM. And in the YouTube search box, and you'll get our channel. And Richard Stone, one of our camera people here, also takes the show, which is directed by Bob Hoke in our video booth, and puts it on our channel. Usually he gets it up by later on this afternoon or this evening. So you can check that out. And also a bunch of the old shows, too. In fact, I was looking at some of the great old shows, and so I think you ought to check that out. It's WMNF 88.5 FM. No periods or anything, just search for that on YouTube and you'll find our very own channel. And the other thing is, when you get to our channel, make sure you like it or subscribe to it. That's it. Make sure you subscribe to it, because when we get a certain number of subscribers, we get a boost. And so, you know, navigating this world of social media, you know, it's a full-time thing. So go to that. Go to YouTube.com and look for WMNF 885 FM. Watch this video of these guys. They're very photogenic.
I was going to say, you're helping us out a lot on the gig front, by the way, because we don't have anything. I mean, this is amazing what you guys do here. And
well, that's great.
We don't have anything like this, you know, of us playing. So.
All right, good. Well, let's have another song.
Sounds great. This one is called Walking Through Mud.
Da 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 da
Please don't turn out the light, baby. Please don't turn out the light. Please don't turn out the light. I'm on my own. Oh, please don't turn out the light, baby. Oh, please don't turn out the light. Please don't turn out the light. I'm on my own. And now I'm walking through snakes. They hiss at my feet. It seems like a nightmare, but I think it's sweet. And maybe I'm frightened, or maybe I'm lonely. If you walk in my shoes, then you might know me. La da 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 da. La da 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 da. Please don't turn out the light, baby. Please don't turn out the light. Please don't turn out the light. I'm on my own. Please don't turn out the light, baby. Please don't turn out the light. Please don't turn out the light. Through fire, just a lick from a flame. It seems out of control, but really it's tame. And I've been here before, Lord, ain't that a fact? Just 'cause I'm hopeless don't mean I'll turn back. Please don't turn out the light, baby. Please don't turn out the light. Please don't turn out the light. I'm on my own. Yeah, yeah. Please don't turn out the light, baby. Please don't turn out the light. Please don't turn out the light. I'm on my own. 'Cause I'm take the train, need a shot to laugh my mind, oh, feel the rain. Wanna walk, oh, take a train, need a shot to laugh my mind, oh, feel the rain. Is da 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 da.
Broke Mr. Jones. That's the name of the band that's on today's live music showcase here from WMNF in Tampa. I'm Bill Dudley, and having a good time listening to these four guys here.
I'm glad.
Who are they, you might ask? Well, we got Elliot Dickinson. He writes the songs. He writes the songs, and he sings them, plays guitar. Greg Baker playing organ and guitar on that last one. Sean Hartley on the bass. And John McDonald is in the drum booth. You can't see him, folks, but he's in there, and it sounds really good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's kind of a song about what, teenage angst there? We just you just sang?
You know,
not sure?
I'm not always sure what my songs are about. I'd love for you know, sometimes I hear that one, I'm like, is that a song about dying? Like I don't really know. Yeah, sometimes it's characters and stuff, so something that they use outside.
It means whatever you want it to mean, I guess, right? One of those deals.
I guess so. It's like a Picasso painting.
Yeah, right. Well, you can check them out at facebook.com/brokemrjones, all one word. And this here live music showcase program is brought to you by WMNF and listeners like you folks. If you want to listen to the show again, just the audio part of it, you can always go to WMNF Archive, and all the shows are there. You just have to know the date of them. And while you're there, we could really use a little contribution to keep this show and this radio station on the air. The tip jar is right there at WMNF.org. And don't forget the video portion of the show, which you can check out on YouTube by typing in WMNF 88.5 FM. Mark Perfetti mixes the show up every week here, just about every week. Today's assisted by Allison Hickey. She's also running a camera today. We've got Bob Hoke directing the video feed, and Richard Stone running the other camera, and Mildred Mattos is our associate producer on this radio show, answering the phones in the control room at WMNF.org. You can send her an email at dj@WMNF.org. Steve Arduengo is our show producer, been doing a great job. He's the guy that books all the folks for the show, the talent, and you can get a hold of him and all of us just by emailing us at livemusic@wmnf.org. And I have one little thing I have to say here. They say when you have your health, you have everything, right?
Sure.
Right. Now, you know what they say. Make sure you know every way that you can to keep your health by listening to Alternative Health every other Monday morning at 10 o'clock, WMNF Community Conscious Radio, for Tampa Bay. And now that my public service has been fulfilled, let's have another song.
Beats the ad time, right? This next one's called Exoskeleton. Gotta get his conscience clear, can't tell what is real. Who's gonna pay for this? When he gets caught, it'll be a mess. Tries to be cool on the outside, instead it just shows what he can't hide. She doesn't even know his name, but that's no change, so it's all the same. You're rigid outside, what can you hide? You break, you open, exoskeleton, la 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 la. Da 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 da.
want to protect herself. Doesn't care about anyone else. Just because she got thick skin doesn't mean the game is hers to win. He said your life is right now and you can't lose. Still she's so damn confused. Put your shield up, eat your heart out. Like you know what this is all about. You'll need it outside. What can you hide? Break you open. Exoskeleton. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Da 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 da.
You got them. They're here live in the studio here at WMNF Tampa. Broke Mr. Jones, the name of the band. We've had several people respond to this show.
Have you?
Facebook, you Stephen Apostolaris contacts us, says, sounds really great, fellas. I'll try and come out and see you.
Awesome.
Thanks, Stephen.
Yeah,
Steven.
Yeah. Is that a friend of yours? Yeah. Well, I guess it is.
He can be. Yeah. and
we had a text message. Somebody said, amazing show. Thanks, guys.
Wonderful.
And Paul from St. Pete called up, and he said, wow, guys, quit your day jobs. That's a great compliment for a musician.
That's the best.
You should quit your day job. Boy, you know, you can't really say anything better than that in some cases.
All eyes turn to me.
What, you're the one with the day job?
I'm the sore thumb, yeah.
You're the responsible party in this group?
Greg's the 9-to-5-er.
Yeah, when I thought...
Some would say a lump on a log, but...
He's going to buy us lunch when we leave.
But I was actually going to... I'm glad this came back up because I was going to mention, I said earlier that the three of us were part-time professional musicians, but he's a part-time professional musician and a full-time employee of... Yeah, has a much better job. See, I can't even describe it because it's just that far above me.
It's just too out there.
Nah. So he's always working double duty, so to speak.
Oh, yeah, and playing some really great guitar here.
Indeed.
I'm really enjoying the show. I'm enjoying all the influences you guys bring to this, particularly songs, you know, and there's such a grab bag of different... sort of styles and things like that, but yet they're definitely fresh.
Okay.
So I'm enjoying that. So
thank you.
Yeah. Good. So when you work out a song, how you bring a song in and then these guys mess with it?
Yeah. Some of the songs that you're hearing today were a little bit more like set when these guys joined the band, and others were like we pretty much wrote them right along, like we all just kind of collaborated on completing them. So some of the songs that John and I used to play, like we were maybe a little bit more particular about like we're kind of feeling this or feeling that, but then everything that came since these guys have been a part of the band, everything that we've worked on fresh has been a cool collaborative kind of thing where I bring them something and then.
How long does it take for them to all figure out an arrangement? Say that song you just did, it had several different parts to it.
Yeah, that happens to be one of the ones that was pretty ironed out beforehand. Yeah. And we haven't changed much since.
So they just put their own little spin on it.
Yeah, but at the same time, I mean, these guys are quick. That's why I love working with all of them.
I'd say it takes us anywhere in a range of like from a sit-down session that'll be a couple hours long to weeks of going back and tweaking and kind of deciding what we actually want this the tune to end up sounding like.
Yeah. So that's John McDonald in the drum booth, folks. John, how much influence do you have on the band as far as these arrangements are concerned? I guess
I don't do any songwriting myself. It's really just all on the arrangement side. And like Elliot mentioned earlier, because it was just the two of us in the band beforehand, mm-hmm. him and I obviously had mostly equal say in how we wanted the tunes to turn out in the end. It hasn't changed. Adding these guys hasn't really changed the amount of influence I have, more or less. It's kind of a fully democratic, collaborative effort.
Yeah. You know? I mean, I really strive to not tell people, like, at least now, this is maybe new for me, but I really strive to not tell people what to play.
Imagine that's hard.
Like, I'd rather tell them, like, what not to play.
Is that hard for you?
Oh, so hard. I'm a control freak at heart, man.
I didn't want to say that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's hard for every musician, honestly.
Yeah.
It's,
well, when you have a concept, you're you're worried people are going to step on your concept.
Yeah. Right. And that's
especially true, yeah.
You got to find people that can kind of see your vision, at least somewhat, you know, the way that you can, and then or at least, and then be willing to help you bring it to life, I guess. So.
Well, play another vision for us.
All right. Oh, man. All right, this is definitely an old tune of ours. Yeah. This one's called Unleash Your Love. It's going to feature some more of Greg playing both guitar and organ and doing those fun swaps.
Don't talk about me while I'm doing this.
To be free, and I feel the same. Oh, your game with me. All that I know, all that I know, is you got a side you certainly have yet to show. Break the chains your mind's made of. Unleash your love, yeah, unleash your love, yeah, unleash your love, oh, unleash your love. Tell me when to unleash it, and just maybe unleash it, and just maybe, yeah, I've chased you around, but so have most. No matter which way I try, I could not get close. Was it something I did, or something I said? Was it just the situation I misread? Break the chains your mind's made of, and you wanna unleash your love. Yeah, unleash your love. Yeah, unleash your love. Yeah, unleash your love. Tell me when to unleash it, and just maybe unleash it. Tell me when to unleash it, and just maybe unleash it. Tell me when to unleash it, and just maybe unleash it. Tell me when to unleash it, and just maybe unleash it. Tell me when to unleash it, and just maybe unleash it. Tell me when to unleash it, and just maybe unleash it. Tell me when to unleash it, and just maybe unleash it. And just maybe unleash it, and just maybe.
Well, I hope you get a chance to watch the either the video or the see some of these guys live. They're really tight, and it sounds like you spend a lot of time working on stuff, getting really tight, and I really appreciate that. It's fun to watch them, folks, and I especially enjoyed the Greg Baker. He's playing organ, and then he switches over to guitar, and just in time to do a little chasing back and forth there with Elliot Dickinson. He's the leader of this band here, I guess. I don't know. Maybe they don't have a leader. Maybe he's just the guy that writes the songs. Anyway, Elliot, Greg, Sean Hartley on the bass, John McDonald on the drums, and they are Broke Mr. Jones. Don't ask why they came up with that name, but just spell it out, Broke Mr. Jones. If you do that on Facebook, you'll find their Facebook page with information about the different places that some of them are going to be playing, and also find out about the new CD, which is coming out any minute now, like in the fall.
Yeah, exactly. Or sooner. Trust me, if we have it ready quicker.
Well, maybe, with the tremendous demand created by this here radio show, maybe.
That would be fantastic.
You have to push it through.
That'd be fantastic.
Some kind of funding campaign to get it out faster, maybe.
I think for the next one, that'll probably be, who knows? Like, a few things will maybe be done differently to expedite the process. Because I know, the problem becomes, as an artist, you don't want to release something that you did 9 months ago. You want to release, the best thing would be to release something that you did yesterday.
Yeah.
Because we're kind of always changing.
But see, it's sort of coming to that with social media and stuff. You can be doing something and then just stick it right on there.
Mm-hmm. And then there's the perfectionist part of us, which just won't allow it to be done.
But
because
it's live.
Yeah. Well, and right. the album was recorded. I mean, you mentioned us being tight. This is how we like to play for sure. The album was pretty much recorded like this, so you get that feel.
Broke Mr. Jones, we got 3 minutes. So do a 3-minute song to take us out here. And thanks, guys, for coming
Test
down
drive.
To be on the live music showcase from WMNF Tampa.
All right, this song is called Test Drive, and this is the bonus. This is not on the not going to be on the album.
Bonus track.
With every curve right where it ought to be. I don't want to wait, don't want you tomorrow. Stay off the brake, keep on the throttle. Yes. No need to make a commitment. Consider it a test drive when you're on my mind.
around here. Always concerned what you're missing, like it's any different for anyone.